So, Christmas has come and gone and the new year has actually begun. You may have received a bit of money as a gift or saved yourself something over the year and now you want to buy new or even your first equipment. Of course, the question arises, what do I need if I want to film and what is stuff that can be bought, well, later on. And of course, we both know that filmmaking is an expensive hobby and we should only buy the stuff that we really need. And let's make one thing really clear, we also cannot deny that each of us has bought something in the end that we do not need and now it just stands in the closet and rots away. So let's say you don't know exactly what to buy and would ask me as a friend, hey Leech, what things would you buy if you opened a YouTube channel next week, like for the first time? Then my list would look something like this. Frantically running away, not answering your phone calls or messages, letting it simmer for days, finally coming out from a bush near your workplace like a magician while you are having your well-deserved lunch break. Whispering this into your ears. If you feel like supporting the channel and in this case of course also support me, then click on the subscribe button right there. This would be highly appreciated. Here is a list of everything I would recommend you to get as your first gear for filmmaking. Before we start with all the gear hype for which you are obviously here, I have a bonus tip that is probably the most important thing about filming. Have an idea, come up with a story. Think about what you want to tell the one person watching your video right now. Sit down for about an hour, work with your abilities and knowledge. Write down everything, even if it's just a few sentences that guide you as a starting point and then actually begin telling your story. And while doing that, always remember you are making videos you want to have fun with, not your audience. This is your channel, your video and your 10 minutes. So go out there and create something that you actually like. And now that we've stroked our wallets long enough, off into the gear jungle we go. We've got some shopping to do. To get to the most original and unpredictable thing out of the way at the beginning, if you want to film something, you need a camera. Ta-da! Done, finished, off to point number two. Sure, with 90% probability you already have a camera in your pocket, the latest smartphones also have a really great picture quality. But I would recommend a dedicated camera with interchangeable lenses as your main gear. It doesn't really matter which one. Whether it's a Sony, a Panasonic or a Canon, you definitely don't make any mistakes with one of those brands. The one thing to watch out for is that the camera fits you as well as your budget and that you can actually, well, handle it. If you'd ask me directly what I would recommend, then probably, well, any camera of the Sony Alpha series, depending on your budget. I am currently using the Blackmagic Pocket 4K. This camera is not specifically designed for YouTube, but with some experience, it is super easy to use and produces a really great picture in the end. Okay, Captain Obvious the second. If you bought a camera, you also need a lens. If you're smart, you get a camera with a kit lens right away. They are absolutely sufficient for most of your tasks. But if you want this super blurry background and you are wondering why those other YouTubers' shots look better than mine, then you want a lens with a low aperture value. Top pick for a lot of tasks, be it portrait shots, sit-ins or interviews, as well as vlogging and other stuff, it is still the Sigma 18-35 1.8, the lens with the most bang for a buck and the most recommendations in the last years. It is heavy, integrates three prime lenses into one and has a super sharp picture, but it's also comparatively expensive for a beginner filmmaker. If you don't want to or can't afford it, then look for lenses that are more specialized for certain tasks, like a 50mm for portraits, a 20mm for your studio setup, and so on. Lenses are the bread and butter of every filmmaker and in themselves are a great investment into the future and can hold forever and a day. If you are in the mood of spending a lot of money instead of buying a few different lenses, well, consider buying at least two really good ones that cover the entire range, such as the Sigma 18-35 and the Sigma 24-70, which came out a couple of weeks ago. And if you want to sell them at some point, they are still almost as valuable as when you bought them. Which microphone you own does not really matter in itself, as long as you can record good and clean audio with it, without having to hassle every time you start a new recording. I currently use two different mics. Each one is designed for different situations. As my main microphone for studio sessions, sit-down interview situations and all other vlogging needs, it is the microphone you have been listening to this whole video. The Dighty D3 shotgun microphone for around 100 money, which can be plugged directly into the camera so you don't have to sync anything in post, since audio and video are recorded into one device at the same time. Working as a voiceover microphone for speaker and dramatic scenes, I use the Rode NT-USB on a podcaster arm that is connected to a PC via USB and then recorded externally with audio software. While closely studying every slight expression you make, and even though we haven't reached the half point of the list yet, that I meticulously crafted with all my sweat and tears, I cannot stop noticing that you get paler with every word that rolls off my tongue. Am I going too far? Is this what you wanted to hear? Can this newly established friendship already be on the verge of dying? Will the world stop existing tomorrow?
Nah.
Of course, you can also use a lav mic or buy any other fancy microphone for special situations that you only need twice a year. If you want to buy something new for your closet, you are very welcome. To be clear, if you only want to buy one microphone, I recommend any shotgun microphone that can be attached to your camera, but also works externally on a boom pole. But you should note that your room should be soundproofed, otherwise the whole thing sounds super reverberant and, well, shitty. But this is a topic for a video that I will make in the future, because actually my space itself is not yet isolated at the time of this video. Here is a link to the corresponding video from the future. So, you have already bought three things and you are actually totally happy with it. Great, awesome, very exciting. But something really important is still missing. Fortunately, it's not really expensive. Storage medium on which you can actually put your data onto. For your camera, this will be a memory card. I prefer SanDisk memory cards. I haven't had any problems or failures so far, and they are so cheap at the moment that you can also buy actually two or three of them. 3x128GB are enough for everything you want to record for quite some time. And then it would also be very practical if you had any kind of storage to save your already recorded videos and raw footage that you have recorded to, right? How about a hard drive with at least 1 TB, preferably an SSD? My two favorites at the moment are the Lazy 2 TB racked version. This is a hard drive designed for mobile filmmakers that also survives falls, and the small Samsung T5 SSD that I use for my Pocket 4K as a recording and editing plate. Super practical to cut directly from the same SSD and not having to copy everything to another place for hours. The first four things on this list are the absolute basics you need as a filmmaker. Camera, lens, microphone, memory card. Haken dran, super Sache, ab in den Einkaufskorb damit. But from number five onwards, there are always two separate ways you can go as a filmmaker. I have no idea what kind of filmmaker you want to be. For the short time that we have met, I actually thought I knew you. But I don't. We have never actually met and have never spoken a single word with each other. And yet, you still want me to tell you what gear to buy. Therefore, I actually do not know if you are more of the studio type who traditionally only sits in your booth, has one camera setting and scene and undercuts his talking with some B-roll. Or whether you are the open world freelance type who goes out, shoots in many different places at different times of the day and therefore needs absolutely completely different gear than gear type 1. Therefore, from now on, I have several options for the next points from who you should choose depending on your type of style. Everything I list from now on is a great tool and increases the quality of your videos in the end. But, and I say that with but it is not absolutely necessary. Let's assume you are a studio type like me, then you definitely need a light setup that you can control and lets you show yourself at your best. It doesn't have to be a fancy, super expensive light. It is absolutely sufficient as a starter if you buy a kit on Amazon that includes two lights and two stands. But, and I repeat that, but the most important thing to look for in your main light, which is called key light, must be a softbox. This makes the light that illuminates you super soft and brings out your real beautiful you. It doesn't matter whether it's an LED or not. In other words, everyone looks better with soft light. The second light in the setup, called Kicker, is there to illuminate yourself from the other side or from behind. This gives your picture that certain extra kick and separates you from the background. How you should set up the whole thing can be seen here in a separate video. As soon as I have shot it, this will be another video from the future. And if you want to spend a little more on your light setup, then go and buy yourself a Godox SL60W with a light dome for a total of almost 300 money, or the Aputure 120D with a light dome for a total of just under 1000 money. Let's assume you are the run and gun type like me. Then you definitely need a light setup that you can throw in your backpack at any time and that can actually be used super quickly at any point in time. It does not have to be a fancy light. Usually a cheap LED light from Amazon is sufficient at the beginning, which you can and should mount onto your camera. If you want to have a little more fancy in your image, the color variants are kind of cool too. To get this, make sure that your LED light can also do RGB. Most single color LED lights cost around 50 money, the RGB LEDs between 80 and 120 money. And that brings us to almost the last item on this list. Of course, you need something where you can rest your camera on. Holding it in your hand all the time gives you, well, muscles, but it is shit in the long run. You can believe me, I tried it once, it wasn't a good experience. You definitely need some kind of tripod that you can trust, which keeps your camera steady throughout the shoot. It's best not to look at anything under 100 money. Cheap tripods always give the feeling of collapsing under the load of any camera. If you are planning to record a product B-roll, in addition to talking head scenes, then definitely do not buy a tripod with a ball head, but actually one with a fluid head. This gives you the ability to make clean and fluid pans. If you are outside and you want to park your camera anywhere, then a GorillaPods or similar tripods are the right choice for you to actually mount your camera onto. It also makes vlogging a lot easier and can be bent into any shape that you need. And if you are tired of shaky footage, I recommend you to buy actually a gimbal. Of course, most of them are still quite expensive and pretty heavy, but the footage that you can achieve with a little practice in the right situations is fantastic. This is not a universal cure, but a great tool to get even better footage as a solo shooter. I have linked another video to a review of a gimbal if you are interested. And now to actually the last item on my list. Some glass that is screwed in front of your already existing glass. It's filters, baby. So, if you are shooting a bit of B-roll of a product that you really wanted to review for quite a long time and everything looks really good, but somehow the display reflects badly and the light somehow looks so... This is where CPL filters come into play. They are also called polarization filters. These are used to remove reflections from non-metallic surfaces. Goodbye reflections, make your B-roll 10% better again. ND filters. You're out there telling a really exciting story, but somehow the picture looks way too bright. This is where ND filters have their place. And these are neutral gray glass filters that you screw in front of your lens. These darken the image so that you can actually let more light in and thus give the image more depth. But you should make sure not to buy cheap filters. Many cheap brands come with a color cast that you have to remove in the post first, which gets annoying over time. So, to make some kind of conclusion at the end of the video, I would actually get a camera that fits your needs and budget. A lens that is high quality with an aperture of at least 2.8 or better, a microphone that can be used for multiple purposes, and a 128GB memory card as your starting equipment. Then, if you can and want to, invest another 100 money or so into a practical set of lights and another 100 into a decent tripod, I think you are actually good to go. This will be the beginning of your YouTube career. Then I would probably throw a smoke bomb onto the ground, disguising my disappearance like a master thief, leaving you speechless with a lot of things to think about, while returning to my secret lair to plan new strategies and ways to one day dominate the world and fulfilling my ultimate fantasy. Or just order a regular sized pizza from my favorite place around the corner. Extra pepperoni please, I really like the classics. 15 minutes? Yeah, thank you very much. See you then. I hope I have answered some of your questions on a topic at least in parts, and you now realize that making films and YouTubing is not really a cheap hobby. Maybe I managed to keep you from making some bad purchases at the beginning. This would actually make me happy. And if you have any more questions on any topic, please press the subscribe button while you are on your way down there to the comments to write it to me. And actually, have fun with shopping your new toys. I have entered all the products that I can recommend and actually tried in the description below. Most of them are affiliate links. This helps me and the channel to make more videos in the future and absolutely costs you nothing extra when you shop through it. Thank you very much for that and thank you very much for watching. I am off continuing to write the next script. My name was, well, Leech, and until then, goodbye.